Well, I moved here in September of 1991. That was my youngest daughter. She was a newborn then when we moved here. She's 26 now. There weren't any tanks over here. None of this was here. You know, there was an open field basically, because it was too close from to burn sugar cane, you know, from the smoke. You know, after they cut the cane, they would have to burn it. Even the farmers had gave us enough respect where they stopped doing that. Okay, so this land was just open, nothing but an open field. And, you know, we had our little deals, but most of it was just when they were harvesting and it would have so much smoke, you know, most folks with respiratory problems have to stay inside. So that 22 years passed by. Then this start, you know, it started. I really couldn't tell you what it was. The city was going to do something over here, and they had like a tower or something over here. You know, I paid no attention. Man, what are they doing? You know, couldn't get an answer. You know, tried to talk to my councilman. Couldn't get any answers. All right, life goes on. Next thing you know, I'm seeing it encroaching from the back. I said, man, what are y'all doing? Oh, I know they were building some more tanks, but they started building numerous of tanks. Then they started building a rail line. Well, if you see the type of those things, that's why they fill up these tank cars, the crude oil. The crude oil is shipped from up north and unloaded. Each way you see one of these little black things, a rail car goes there. For each one you see, a rail car goes there. And they do it at night, you know. And I'm thinking, man, what are the dangers? All the time I hear about of these rail cars turning over, catching fire, and folks have to evacuate, you know? I'm saying, man, this is dangerous, you know? So like I said, we talked to the gentleman at New Star, the guy over the New Star plant. Oh, he said, oh, well, what do y'all want to do? My father said, buy us out. We just had open heart surgery. My mother-in-law had open heart surgery. Now she had both her legs amputated. And, you know, we can't, if something would happen, we can't evacuate. If something happened in the front of this lane, at the front of the road, see if one of those tanks catch a fire up in the front, we're boxed in. If something happened in the back, we're boxed in. If something happened 150 feet from my house, I'm gone. I said, what y'all gonna do about that in case of explosions? Oh, we're gonna build a levee, a levee, you know? And they didn't tell me, another contractor told me they're gonna build a levee, so I don't have to see what's going on. So we went back and forth with this guy, back and forth with this guy. You know, he came and he met a few of us. Everybody's saying the same thing. Buy us out. Buy us out. Then it came, months went by. The pastor said, man, what is the problem now? Oh, what the problem is, this is Marathon. Another natural food giant. Those tanks over there, all that is owned by Marathon. All that back in the backside is owned by Marathon. They said, well, Marathon is going to have to agree also. You know? I said, what you mean Marathon is going to have to agree? I said, you're right here. Yeah, I said, you're closest to me. Oh, but Marathon got to do this, and we're going to have to negotiate with Marathon to try to accomplish something. I said, man, this is ridiculous. You know? Now there's no word. You know? Now what they're doing is, since they're figuring that this is getting out on the news and to the outside world, what they do is they usually light it up like day back here. Now what to do, to keep the lighting down. See that usually during the daytime now, you'll be hearing the trains. You'll be hearing the rail cars slamming together. And like I told him, I said, man, look, I grew up down there. I know what these rail cars do. They leak, you know, they turn over, they catch fire. Oh no, this is new. This is new technology. I said, I don't know about the new technology, but every one of these stir facility, they leak. Accidents happen. Now, when it's gonna happen, how it's gonna happen, I don't know. But eventually it's gonna happen. It's happened before, time after time after time. You can go to different places and different cities that had these places. They leak, they catch fire.
Tell me on a bad day what it's like when you come out the door.
Eggs. Rotten eggs. A sulfur smell. You smell the sulfur. Crude oil is, it's a sulfur smell. It smells like sulfur, you know? At night, on a foggy night, you really can smell it. You know, it gets in the fog. As it lifts, the fog is holding it down. And it's real foggy, you can see the fog. Next morning I come up on my vehicle, you can see it. You know, you can see it, you know, and you can smell it. You know, and it's always something. Either you start gonna say, oh, it must have been marathon. You know, a marathon gonna say, oh, it was. They're not gonna shut down. They're not gonna shut down. That's a multi-million dollar industry over here. They're not gonna shut it down. And for a handful of families that live back here now, because most people, like I said, are dying out. These folks are dying out, you know? And there's not gonna be anybody back here, you know? And I believe that's their plan, you know, to wait us out, you know? I didn't ask you to come here. I disagree with your tactics of coming here, you know? When I spoke to you directly, you know, to buy us out, you ask what you wanted. New Star asked what they wanted, what we wanted from them. And we told them, buy us out. Get us from around here. I don't want to, I wasn't living here for over 20 years before you come here with your tank cars, with your tanks right in my front yard. You know, you bought everybody else out. Everybody else out. Do you see anybody on that side, to the front of the street? Nobody. Everybody bought out.
So if they did buy the houses across the street from you out?
All of that, the people, the property, see this property?
Uh-huh.
They're on that property from, you made my house, is I'll eat all, family will eat. We get around with the kids and get together. My daughter's growing up with my granddaughter. She'll be up with me, we'll talk. Then she'll go to sleep. Then my wife will go to sleep. Then I'll be up. I cannot rest. I can't rest peacefully because I know I live next to a time bomb. I know if something happens, I'm gonna have a matter of minutes to get me and my family out of here. I know this. So when you try to lay down and you're hearing tank cars slamming together, slamming, boom, you're hearing booming sounds. First thing I'm thinking, explosion, you know? And like I said, I'm so concerned with it, I don't sleep at night. I don't. I might go to sleep at 3:30 or 4 o'clock in the morning. Whenever my wife gets up to go to work and she's out the house, I'll go to sleep. Because I make sure she gets in the car okay. Then I'll go to sleep. But other than that, it's late night for me. You know, permit to do this. Oh, we did it with the parish president and your councilman. I said, my councilman? Hell yeah, your councilman was supposed to come in and tell us what was going on. I said, nobody never told me anything. I said, why y'all didn't come and post it in the community? Oh, well, I don't know why you had to talk to your councilman. Talk to the councilman. And that didn't come out work out too good. So like I told him, after arguing with him, I said, I know what to do with you. I know how I can deal with you. We'll just vote you out. So that's the ex-councilman that did this, that was with this. So he's out of office. But the problem is still here. It's still here. And nothing ever happened. Like I would tell everybody, when I walk out my house, I look that way, there's tanks and rail cars. When I look behind me, there's tanks. I'm surrounded. My neighbors are surrounded. These people are poisoning us. They're releasing chemicals into there. You know, I had a breakdown on crude oil. The benzene is cancerous. And like I was telling the folks at this meeting, the lady that lived right here, she died with cancer. The other two neighbors, the husband and the wife, they died of cancer. My neighbor back here, him and his wife died of cancer. You know, just from the storage facilities. And after a while, it accumulates. You know, they was here before. Whenever I got married, my mother-in-law and father-in-law lived here for almost 50 years now. You know, of breathing this in daily. And eventually it catches up with you. So when I say that I'm tired of living and let live, I'm tired. I'm talking about living and let live. I've tried living and let live in this world. But when you see folks that just walk over you, when you see folks that figure you can't hire a large law firm, you know, you don't have the financial means of fighting these folks, you know, and this is the only thing these folks understand. Common sense doesn't matter to them. I found dealing with these guys, dealing with Newstore, that it doesn't matter to them. It doesn't. You know, and like I told them, this is about simple economics. You bought all of this property from these folks in the front. They bought out the store. The only store we had around here, they bought the store, tore it down, and made a parking lot out of it. But you bought the community. We had one little store. You buy it and make a parking lot.
Can you tell me when that happened?
Whenever the Newstore came.
And that was, do you know which year?
This is 2012.